Hello everyone. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can use a combination of ChatGPT AI and knowledge graphs to analyze any video on YouTube and see what it's about. So you can take something like this interview between Sam Altman and Lex Fridman, for instance, and see what are the main topics inside, how they're related to one another, and more importantly, zoom into one of the topics. So for example, here I will go into the GPT model system, see which part of the video they were talking about this particular topic, open the video at this.
I think this is the most capable.
Very place. And then use the built-in AI tools to generate some interesting ideas in relation to the content of the video. So that, for example, you take some of the stuff that you select and then use the built-in GPT-4 to generate some ideas that can help you think about the content in this video, pose interesting questions and develop the content further. So keep watching if you want to learn how it works. First of all, we'll be using a tool that's called InfraNodus that visualizes and analyzes any text as a network using a combination of knowledge graph tools and ChatGPT AI. And the way that you can import any video into the tool is very simple. You just go to the video and then you copy and paste the link. So for example, in this case, it's the interview between Lex Fridman and Sam Altman. And then you click add new text, simply add the link. Automatically, it will identify it's from YouTube. You choose the YouTube site titles option, and then it will be visualized in seconds as a knowledge graph, where the words that they use in this conversation are the nodes and co-occurrences are the connections. And then based on these words and connections, we build topical clusters, so words that they tend to use together in the same context. Now, as it's a conversation between two people, of course, you have a lot of what we call parasite words, like a lot, thing, yeah, and so on. So you can remove them all very quickly by clicking this button, reveal underlying ideas. So it just gets rid of the most frequently used terms that maybe are not relevant to the conversation. So for example, in this case, let's also get rid of yeah and lot, and we hide them. You can also do it through the graph. And here we get to a much more precise structure where we see that the terms that they used in the conversation are GPT, AI, human, good, world, and so on, right? And then if you click here, you can also use GPT-4 to reveal underlying ideas. So you can see that the main topics of the conversation are AI ethics, human knowledge, AGI development, and GPT-3 advancements. So that gives you a really good idea of what the video is about. Now, let's say you want to jump into one of those topics and see what they were talking about, some particular topic, like for instance, in this case, AGI development. So if you click on this topic, you will actually have the statements that belong to this topic filtered here. So these are the time codes from the video where you can jump directly to the parts of the video where they were talking about these topics. If I want to be more precise, I can even click on some notes. I can switch this off and just go like AGI and let's expand this topic. So AGI technology and build, for instance, right? So I select three nodes. As we see, they belong to the topic of AGI development, but span into other subjects as well. So it means it's a very interdisciplinary concept in the context of this conversation. And here I have all the terms, all the statements where they talked about these particular topics in this conversation. So if I scroll through, I see the time codes and the links to the video. So if I want to hear about building AGI technology, I can just click here and it will jump exactly to the part of the video
like,
where they're talking about,
you know,
this.
These people aren't very good and it's ridiculous to talk about AGI and I can't believe you're giving them time of day. And it's like, that was the level of like pettiness
so
and rancor in the...
Here, Sam Altman is talking about the difficulties of building the company, right? So we jump exactly to the part where he's talking about AGI technology. We can also scroll through more and see some other stuff. So for example, if I really want to focus, let's say on AGI technology, let's see if there is something here that we can find. So for example, here.
AGI, out of all the technologies we have in our hands, is the potential to make,
So as you can see, we jump directly to the parts of the video where they're talking about the stuff that we're interested in. So this becomes a really good tool to watch a video in a non-linear way, where you can really navigate through the content based on your interests. Now, we already use the AI to generate the names for those topics, and this is very useful, but let's take it one step further. So in InfraNodus, you have this special tab that's called blind spots that identifies the topics that could be better connected, but are not yet. And then it proposes to make a connection between them. And you can actually reiterate through a few gaps. So what I like to always do is to find the parts of the graph that are somehow a little bit separated from each other or that are not so well connected. So for example, in this case, let's say AI alignment and machine learning, right? So this one is more on that side of the graph and this one is more at the bottom part of the graph. And then what it does is that you can actually send this gap to the built-in AI, which uses GPT-4 at the background, to generate a question that would link those two groups of concepts together. And this is a really good way to jump into a conversation with an interest that might be not so evident from the surface of the video, right? But you can really jump to the topic that you think will connect ideas in a new way. So for example, here it proposes us to think of how can the incorporation of superintelligence into the early training of large data sets help to solve the problem of bias alignment in machine learning models. So this is great. You see, it's a very specific question, and if we take this question before watching the video, we will get much more information from it because we will have a really precise way of approaching it. And we might even want to ask ChatGPT itself, like what it thinks about this question that emerged from the conversation. So if I click on elaborate here and then click on GPT-4 chat, it's going to send this question back to itself and try to respond to this question. Now it uses all the scope of knowledge that it has, but you can also limit it to the actual video, and then you will sort of interact with the video based on that question that you identified using the gap. But as it's a gap, probably it will be a little bit difficult to find the answer to this question in the video itself. So this is why we use the general intelligence of the model to come up with some ideas. So this is a sort of like a workflow that you could use to engage into an interaction with the model. Now, this is a very good tool if you just want to also get a general idea about the content of any video. So for example, here, let's say if I take another interviewer with Lex. So for example, actually I wanted to analyze one with Joshua Bach. Let's find it. Where is that? Joshua Bach. Okay, we have this one.
Do this in any bad
so
way.
So, as you see, it's almost 3 hours long. Let's go back to InfraNodus. We add this video using create a new text graph link. Copy and paste the link inside. Visualize. Let's see what happens. And here we have a quick representation of what Joshua Bach and Lex Fridman talked about. Let's get rid of some of the words that we don't need. So is the only one that we probably don't want in this visualization. And then we see a knowledge graph of the main ideas. We can click here, review high-level ideas. You can also use this button here on the right. And then it tells us, okay, they're talking about artificial intelligence, creation, mind, conscious agency, human emotion. So a quite range of topics. And then if we click expand here, we can see all the topics they have been talking about. So as you can see, there's quite a lot of interesting stuff about human existence, complex systems, AI, ethics, and so on. So even if I watched this conversation before, it's a great tool to jump back into the parts that I might find interesting. So for example, if let's say I want to see what they had to say about human existence, I can click here. I see that it was quite a peripheral cluster of the conversation, so it was not by all means central. And if I click here, I see an extract of all the time codes in the video where they talk about this subject. Now, if I click here, summarize videos, it will take those visible statements that I filtered using the topic of human existence and summarize them for me using GPT-4, the model that powers ChatGPT. Right, so here I can see that they're talking about the interface between the minds and the outside world and how our attitudes and feelings inform our actions and problem solving. They also touch on the potential for technology to give rise to advanced biological agents. So this is great. It reminds me a really nice part of the conversation. The speaker also considers the concept of intuition and how it relates to our understanding of the world and our place in it. Great. Now, instead of watching this part of the video, I can see very clearly what they talked about. And if I decide I want to jump into this conversation, I can click on one of those terms. And by the way, here I see also which terms are used inside. So for example, let's say I want to see what they talked about people, world, and model. I click on this part of the video, jump directly to the time
code. And that system is powerful.
People call this intuition, right? Intuition is this unreflected part of...
So this is really great. You can try it out on InfraNodus.com with any video. And by the way, as we hear, I also want to show you another little feature, like a bonus track that we have, a new Chrome extension for InfraNodus, which you can also use to analyze videos in the same way. In this case, it's not going to save the data to your user account, but I have the InfraNodus extension here. It also appears here. So if I click on it right now, it's going to do the same thing. It's going to send the content of the video to InfraNodus, identify the gap between two different topics that could be connected better. But also, for example, in this case, it's artificial intelligence and human existence, exploring new ideas and gaining perspective and understanding through life experiences, and then automatically generates a research question that bridges those ideas together. So in this case, how does the integration of artificial intelligence in daily life impact human perception and perspective on the concept of self-identity? So it's a great question, a really interesting question that arises from the conversation, which I can then use to jump back into the conversation or to develop my own ideas. So InfraNodus does this very well for you and with you. It helps you not only summarize the content, which can be interesting, but to also see where you can take this content further. And this is why I'm really excited about this feature, and I hope you will be too. And then if you click here on the topics, then you can see what all the main topics are. And then if you click on the summary, then it will generate a summary for all of those topics for you and tell you that they're about artificial intelligence, virtual world, human emotions, conscious mind, and so on. So then kind of like generating a short description of what they're all about, right? So if you go here
and
to the video,
that system is powerful.
And then you go to topics and then click on summary, it's going to do basically the same thing. It's going to send those topics to the system and then summarize what this conversation is about for you in one short sentence, which you can then copy and paste and use elsewhere. So this is how you would also use this Chrome extension. And if you're interested to try it out, you can write to us, leave a comment to this video, and we'll send you a copy for beta testing. So I hope you enjoyed this presentation and that you will play around with this new YouTube video analysis and visualization feature. Let me know how it works for you. Also, please remember to subscribe to this channel and to turn on notifications so you get informed when the next videos are out. There are not so many of them, but each one is an interesting one. I promise it to you. And also don't forget to leave a like so that other people can see it. And if you have any questions or comments or feedback, please let me know. Thank you.